The question, what happens to your brain when you die, has gone unanswered since the beginning of human civilization. Why is that? Well, researching a person's brain when they die was seen as unethical and controversial. Well, neuroscientists have finally figured out the answer, and apparently Star Trek was right all along. Hey, I'm Charlotte and you're watching Inform Overload. Scientists at the Berlin University of Medicine as well as the University of Cincinnati examined patients who had suffered from serious brain injuries. The Do Not Resuscitate order was activated with these patients, which is the only reason why it was ethical. According to their research, the human brain can work for minutes after the heart stops beating. The heart supplies oxygen to the brain and the rest of the body, but when the heart stops, the brain can't get the oxygen that it needs. Within 20 to 40 seconds of the heart stopping, cerebral ischemia begins. This is where neurons go into a type of sleep mode in order to conserve the energy that they have left. Apparently, even though the brain is technically inactive at this point, it could theoretically be brought back to life. After a few minutes, what is known as a brain tsunami occurs. It's basically a wave of neuroelectrical activity that sweeps through the brain. According to IFL Science, the reason for this is the brain can't maintain the uneven distribution of ions between the inside and outside of nerve cells, so the neurons depolarize and let out a surge of electrochemical energy. Interestingly, Star Trek The Next Generation described this process in a 1988 episode. In the episode, Commander Beverly Crusher notes that Lieutenant Yars's brain can still be brought back to life, even though there's no brain activity. Another crew member says neurons are beginning to depolarize, which is exactly what's explained in this study, which was published more than 30 years later. Are the writers of Star Trek time travelers? Apex TV should interview them. But the answer to that is probably not. It's actually been known for quite some time that a similar process happens in animals' brains when they die. It just hadn't been studied in humans until recently. For ethical reasons. This study has been published in the journal The Annals of Neurology. Okie dokie, it's time to respond to some comments. Comment dance, do the comment dance. Poppy Natal said, Charlotte equals busy potato. Very busy, we are filming extra videos over the next couple days because the team is being flown out to Playlist Live in Orlando. Eyebally-derpy-face, is that your name? I don't know. I love IO because I can outsmart my mom, dad, and my teachers. I love outsmarting adults. Wait. I am an adult. I forget sometimes. Kylie Graves said, I love this because it's not as scary as the news on TV. Really? Next on IO, a giant meteor is going to crash into your house. Your house. That is all, folks. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you leave a like and subscribe and turn on notifications. If you want to stay on this channel, there's a playlist right here that we put together just for you. By the way, IO is on social media. We got Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. Scroll down to the description for all our links. See you later.